Russia is rich in natural resources, including oil and gas. The country also has strengths in nuclear technology, engineering, and military hardware. India has been a buyer of these products from Russia and also participated in joint production in some cases. With Russia keen to expand its economic relationship with the BRICS countries and especially with India, we spoke to the Russian Trade Commissioner on the opportunities that Russia offers and the present state of the Russian economy.
I think that we already used to work in such environment, I mean sanctions environment nowadays. Of course, the GDP is declining and we are waiting it will decline 2.7 or maybe even 3% this year. But still, the first shock we get from the sanctions now overcomes, and so we're quite optimistic about the development. If you take, for example, figures for trade turnover, for export of Russia, so you will see a decline in value, but in volumes, physical volumes, it is increasing. It's increasing in raw materials, in machinery, and non-raw materials products. I think that this situation could be better soon. And of course, sanctions helped us to look more attentively, maybe how to say better, to the opportunities in the East, in India, in China. And now if you see the St. Petersburg Economic Forum, India was one of the biggest delegations at the forum. And of course, we see that businessmen from Asia countries come into Russia, look at the opportunities, and I think it could be very good results of this work.
When you say that Russia is now looking east, and especially to countries like India, could you be more specific as to which areas are you looking to work with, especially in India?
I can tell you that the sanctions came in the same time that a new government of Narendra Modi came to power. That's why we even can tell that we have some developments in cooperation just in the end of last year. I mean India-Russian summit in December. Then Mr. Putin visited India, and we can tell that we signed deals about $100 billion. It's in nuclear sphere, it's in crude supplies to India, it's in raw diamonds, in helicopter construction, and other spheres. I can tell you that we are waiting for new deals, then the next summit, bilateral summit, will be later this year in Russia. And in this way I can count on the spheres like railways, infrastructure development, and the railway equipment supplies to India mostly. So you know that nowadays MOU is preparing for signing in July at BRICS summit between Russian railways and Ministry of Railways of India. They are talking about very, very huge participation of Russia in railways development in India.
When you talk of participation, what do you mean by that? Is it a technological thing?
No, not only.
Parts as well?
Russian companies ready to construct tracks as well.
So it's a joint participation in India with the Indian railways?
So we are talking also in participation in the construction of industrial corridors in India, not only supply of rolling stocks, or, for example, it is a very good opportunities for Russia to improve movement of tracks to make speed higher. And I think we have very good technologies and very good experience in Russia, because we do the same things in Russia already. Nowadays, very big Indian private and public construction companies are in talks with Russian counterparts regarding construction projects. And today, you know that your prime minister announced three major initiatives regarding smart cities, housing for all, and modernization of towns. So I think that we have a lot of experience in smart cities. We can share this experience and to do a lot of things in India. So this is the next sphere, construction of housing and so on. We can talk about participation of Russian companies in Ganga cleaning initiatives, because we have also a lot of experience in water treatment and water linking as well, and improving inland water links, so which is important for India nowadays. So this is spheres: nuclear, oil and gas, machine building, aviation, space as well, construction, infrastructure construction. This, I think, enough to have something serious and serious projects.
What about the private sector? And I'm talking of small and medium enterprises as well as large business in the private sector participating. So do you see that as being an area that could be developed in the future?
I can tell you that just maybe a few years ago, we saw investment mostly by, except maybe MTS, Sistema, mostly by government enterprises. But now we see that more and more private initiatives come to light. And just last year, a plant constructed by a Russian company, Lighting Technology, was opened near Bangalore. It was just 100% FDI from Russia. As regards Indian business, you know reports about Berger Paints investing in Stavropol region. Just today we saw reports about major Indian auto component manufacturer Setco Automotives. They eyes for investments in Russia for gear production for trucks. So this is very serious investments, and I think other side that Russian companies can participate in Make in India program or initiative. So during the February business mission of Russian companies, Russian machine building companies, there were talks regarding Russian help for Indian project for turbine locomotive manufacturing. India has its project, but it Indian people in charge of this project, they have some problems in to make Indian locomotive more, maybe less noisy, but we already at the final stage for certification of Russian turbo locomotive, and so we can share our experience for Indian railways, because it is more effective, this locomotive. It can push more load on the tracks, and I think for India, designing huge industrial corridors, it will be very, very important to have very powerful locomotives at the rails.
What about small and medium enterprises in the feeder zone? So SMEs that manufacture and feed large enterprises and get involved in these larger projects that you mentioned. How can they get information on opportunities that may exist there?
So for this purpose, Trade Commission exists, I can tell you.
And also to look for partners in Russia,
yes,
who may be interested in India.
I can tell you that when I came to India last year, so we saw the growth of inquiries from Russian companies and mostly from small and medium business, just to maybe sell goods, especially medical equipment or even food goods to India. But nowadays I see the situation that to this flow of Russian inquiries, we get in the Trade Commission a flow from Indian companies for partners in Russia. And what we are doing presently, we're trying to find partners between Indian and Russian companies to, manage flows, how to do more effective their cooperation. And of course, we have a lot of forums to promote such things. I can tell you that at the beginning of July will be the meeting of a contact group of trade and economic cooperation within BRICS format. And they also will have a seminar how the government can support cooperation between small and medium enterprises within the BRICS. Russian side even proposed to establish a working group just to do a lot of things, not only government support, but maybe even sometimes we need, we have language barriers and have a lack of information regarding promoting of business of small and medium enterprises. No, I'm not sure that the working group will be established, but this topic is very, very important within the BRICS cooperation, and I think it will be some results in this sphere. But otherwise, Russian Trade Commission is open for inquiries from the Indian and Russian companies as well. Russian, of course, the most priority, because our main task, I mean, Russian Trade Commission, is just to promote Russian export. But of course, if we now trade, just trade is not enough for developing cooperation. We should find opportunities for joint projects, joint manufacturing, joint development of something. And of course, I'm glad that we today have such flows of inquiries from both sides.